I'm Shelia Sanyal. I was born in Balwant Kaur Musi in Kamalpur in 1930. My other brother was born on a Rakhi day. We were sent away from home because children were born at home and our parents didn't want us to be around when the child was born. I remember his small wrist and I put the Rakhi on him and then my sister put the Rakhi on him. When this brother, Jitendra brother, was about 1.5 years old, my father came and said that you have to come to Goa, where he was supposed to. So we all got ready and went with him. And we enjoyed our school. In fact, I remember I have most memories of that school. Gurgaon, we learned most of the things. Because our principal was a Christian lady called Miss Brown. She taught us a lot of manners. And those things have stayed with me all these years. And then after 1 or 2 years, I was told, you have been selected as a bluebird. And tomorrow you get your white salwar and white shirt and a blue chunni, a bluebird. And next day I was ready more earlier than anyone else. So I had my blue dress ready and we were taught the bluebird songs. My father was transferred from Sargodha to Rohtak. Government servants are very obedient in those days, don't ask any question. So he left us around the 1st of August to join his work and then come back and take us to Rohtak. But once he reached there, things were getting worse and he was finding it difficult to come back. And we noticed that. And every day he said, I'll come day after. My mother said, no, he's creating great difficulty. He managed to reach on the 12th of August when the last normal train passed from Pakistan to India. And when he was in Lahore, the train was attacked. He took out his pagri, and he sat on the pagri and he said, Tawa, Tawa, and he acted like a Muslim. And he was saved. Mm-hmm. So he had a clean shaven, you know, a nicely cut hair, no bodhi, and he got away. Muslims came, saw him, went away. He's a Muslim. Okay. And then he came to Sargodha, and then he was very reticent. One day I did ask him, I said, Bhaji, any chance of our getting back, getting away from this massacre? But it so happened that a deputy commissioner of that area was a very secular person. He had given a warning that people moved within 3 miles of radius of Sargodha. I cannot save Hindus living in far-flung areas of Sargodha district villages. Please move to the city. And we were already in the city, so there was a lot of safety. And people had begun to then sell their things. They knew they cannot take away them. Anyway, so things began to get worse. It came, then it was after August, September, October, we got a permit to leave. When we came out of the college and came to that road where the buses were standing, our family was the sole occupant of a one whole bus. I mean, there were so many empty buses. It was quite in the evening when we got into the bus and the bus started. And we were tired and my parents were sad. I was excited that we are going to a new country. And then I was sleepy. Then suddenly I heard, Bole Sonia Sasriya ka. Oh, kya hua? Vaga station aa gaya. And they came with garlands and they came with sweets. And so when things were normal in Jamshedpur, in January, my father said the schools have opened, schools and colleges have opened, and Jeet is supposed to get married. So, Lal, please bring the children back to Rohtak because they have to go to the schools and colleges. There, we heard that Mahatma Gandhi was shot, and that was a very, very sad day for the country. There was a silence in the whole country. You could feel the silence. And then Panditji's speech, the light is gone. I heard that on the radio myself. 3 or 4 days later, we boarded the train and came to Rohtak.